Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can actually read or fetch data from your MongoDB database. So in the previous video, I showed you how to actually create data, and a link to that will be in the video description. However, with that said, we're going to want to insert a few more things. Let's just change the username to Bob. Going back, if I click on refresh, we now see two documents. Now there's some similarities here. Only the username has changed, but the password and email are the same. And so we can actually use that to search through all the documents within our collection. So I'm actually going to get rid of all of this code right here. And I'm going to say constant result equals await user schema dot find. If I minimize my console, we see that there's a lot of different options here. We can find by ID and delete. We can update something. We can find one. We can just find. And so there's many different options here. Let's say we want to just find right here. And if I were to just pass in an empty object, I could then console log the result, just like this. Now if I save this code and I go into my console, I can then run node index.js. And we see an array with both documents in it. We see one with the username Joe and one with the username Bob. However, what if we only wanted to find documents that had the username Joe? Well, within this object, we can add the username property. And the value will be Joe. We can then save this and I can run the code again. And here we see an array that has one document inside of it with the username Joe. And so we no longer see the Bob document because it does not match the requirements within this identifier. Now, alternatively, they both have the same password. So we can actually search for that. So we can say password is going to be password one exclamation point. Now, if I save this, what do you think is going to happen when I run the code? We now see both documents because it actually has the same exact password property. Now, when I did the dropdown a few minutes ago, we saw many different options. I will be covering a lot of those in future videos, but one more I want to cover is findOne. This is going to actually return only one document within the search query. So whichever one it finds first. So I can actually run node index.js here. And we see an object instead of an array, and we see it only returns Joe. Now, once it found one that matched this requirement, it's just going to return that immediately. This is typically faster than .find because it won't have to go through every single document within the collection. However, sometimes you want to use .find because you want many different results, whereas findOne is useful if you're specifically looking for one, as the name implies. And so this is a couple different basic ways that you can actually search through data using MongoDB. Thanks for watching this MongoDB tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warren Off Keys Discord, which will be linked in the video description. If you want to learn more about MongoDB, you can consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.